This video is sponsored by Magellan TV. As part of a plan to build a strategic bomber for deep penetration and nuclear bombing runs during the Cold War, North American Aviation created a stunningly futuristic prototype for its time, the XB-70 Valkyrie. Designed for the U.S. Air Force Strategic Air Command in the 1950s, the Valkyrie was capable of achieving Mach 3 while flying at an astonishing 70,000 feet. The Air Force expected its new aircraft to be immune to jet interceptors. The Valkyrie's speed would require constant switching between radar stations, making it nearly impossible to track. Nevertheless, the project would eventually come under pressure due to the Soviets' development of anti-aircraft missiles that negated the bomber's height and speed advantages. The aircraft's designers also failed to foresee the development of intercontinental ballistic missiles that could reach even higher speeds and altitudes unparalleled for nuclear delivery. The XB-70 would become a beautiful but unnecessary piece of aviation technology, and its fate would be sealed after a tragic accident involving the XB-70's second prototype. The XB-70 was a modern marvel. It was to be something akin to a nuclear-armed Concorde. However, it and the supersonic passenger airliner are no longer around today. So what's the future of commercial aviation? Check out the new documentary Airbus from Magellan TV that explores what it takes to build the most modern commercial aircraft in the world, the A350. Magellan TV is a new type of documentary streaming membership created by filmmakers that brings over 2,000 documentaries to all of your devices. Visit try.magellantv.com/darkskies or click the link in the description below to get a free one-month trial. Explore the Magellan TV series Mega Manufacturing, featuring documentaries that reveal how some of the biggest products in the world are made. Take a behind-the-scenes visit to the Airbus A350 factory and support Dark Skies. Check out Magellan TV with your one-month free trial today. New programs are being added on a weekly basis. Be sure to click on the link in the description below or visit try.magellantv.com/darkskies. Development. The XB-70 Valkyrie was an experimental aircraft developed by North American Aviation. Its features were remarkable. Notably, its size was the largest of any type of plane in the history of aviation. The Valkyrie's airframe featured a long fuselage with a horizontal stabilizer placed behind the crew compartment. It had delta wings swept at 65.5%. To grant greater lateral directional stability, its wing sections could be folded down during flight. The airplane had a movable outer windshield explicitly designed for high-speed flights to reduce drag and increase visibility. The fuselage was constructed with riveted titanium, as was the aircraft's covering. The rest was made almost entirely with stainless steel, its surface brazed with a stainless steel honeycomb material. To power the plane, 6 General Electric YJ-933 turbojet engines were installed, each with 30,000 pounds of thrust. Inside the engines, it could maintain efficient airflow due to geometric inlets. Flying at Mach 3 at altitudes of 70,000 feet, it became the world's largest high-speed experimental aircraft. Data collected from its testing would serve to plan for future military and civilian designs. The Valkyrie program's primary goals were to collect data on its stability and handling characteristics. They wanted to assess its response to turbulence and examine its aerodynamic and propulsion systems. Furthermore, operators sought to record noise and airflow friction to determine the extent of noise pollution emanating from the engine during takeoff, landing, and taxiing. The aircraft was escorted by a TB-58 during its research flights. That plane was chosen due to its ability to dash at Mach 2. In March 1967, NASA took over management of the program they'd shared with the Air Force. 2 prototypes. Only 2 XB-70A prototypes were built by North American Aviation. On September 1, 1964, its maiden flight took off from Palmdale, California, and landed at Edwards Air Force Base. Tests of the aircraft's airworthiness took place between 1964 and 65, conducted by test pilots from both North American Aviation and the U.S. Air Force. The second prototype was built with a few adaptations recommended by the NASA Ames Research Center in Moffett Field after wind tunnel tests. One of the findings revealed that the first prototype had poor directional stability when flown at speeds beyond Mach 2.5, which led to it being a prototype that only carried out a single Mach 3 flight. Therefore, the second prototype adopted 5 additional degrees of dihedral at the wings. Both the Air Force and NASA signed a joint agreement to use this newer prototype to conduct high-speed research flights. This would lead to new projects through the American Supersonic Transport Program, or SST. Unfortunately, these plans were partially disrupted by one of the best-known and most tragic accidents in the history of military aviation at the start of 1966. A stunning crash. President John F. Kennedy officially endorsed the creation of an American supersonic transport through a signed initiative in 1961. The hope was to create a commercial transport aircraft to ferry civilians at three times the speed of sound. This aviation dream began in the 50s when it first became possible from a purely technical and mechanical standpoint. Such developments were contested due to challenges with noise generation, high development and construction costs, increased fuel consumption, environmental concerns, and value to the consumer. Still, they present a possible future for aircraft development that is still considered to this day. As part of the initiative, the Flight Research Center at Edwards Air Force Base, known today as the Dryden Flight Research Center, began test flights with a Navy A-5A Vigilante in 1963. It started by studying the effects of landing a high-speed aircraft in the vicinity of heavily crowded air traffic. The pilots would approach the base, but land at LAX to establish more realistic simulations using supersonic transport planes in a high-volume commercial environment. As a follow-up to the initial effort, they would start using the Valkyrie. The XB-70 was considered an enormous plane for the period. The cockpit's height was 3 stories tall, while its delta wing spanned 105 feet with a body of 185 feet. As stated before, it used 6 powerful General Electric YJ-93 heat engines that could fly 3 times the speed of sound, and the airframe was constructed from stainless steel rather than aluminum, adding significant weight. Furthermore, the design featured modern aerodynamic elements such as canards and sloping wingtips. Despite all of this, the plane never made it into production. The Air Force wanted to hand over the second prototype to NASA in June 1966 for these research purposes. However, they first wanted a photo shoot. General Electric was particularly interested in a group formation photo with the planes that used its jet engines. For the photo shoot, an F-48 Phantom, YF-5A Freedom Fighter, F-104N Starfighter, T-38A Talon, and the second prototype of the XB-70 were brought out to the Californian desert by Edwards Air Force Base on June 8, 1966. To photograph the lineup in flight, a pilot flew a private Learjet owned at the time by none other than Frank Sinatra. The F-104 flew to the right of the XB-70 by Flight Research Center Chief Pilot Joe Walker. Unfortunately, and perhaps unintentionally, he steered the F-104 too close to the Valkyrie. The Starfighter clipped its right wingtip, which caused it to roll up and over, hitting the right vertical fin and tearing off the left. Then, as the ultimate consequence, the Starfighter exploded into a ball of flames and veered to the left. Walker was killed. For about 15 seconds, it seemed the Valkyrie would be fine, as it continued to fly straight at altitude. Then it began to slowly spiral. Pieces of the wing flew away, and fuel leaked out of the sky. Reportedly, one of the chase pilots yelled over the radio, quote, "Eject! Eject!" But Air Force Major Carl Cross couldn't. The pilot, Alvin S. White, managed to get out before the plane crashed into the hills. The investigation later reported that the wake of the Valkyrie's vortex wingtips were to blame. While the science behind vortices wasn't as well researched at the time, all that was known was that the micro-tornadoes emerging from the plane's wingtips caused lethal damage. Furthermore, the Air Force concluded that the F-104 was unable to see the XB-70's wings from their position unless the pilot uncomfortably turned his head. Limited operation. Even today, the Valkyrie holds the record for being the most massive and most heavy plane to ever fly at Mach 3. It proved what it set out to. The high altitude, high speed, and performance of the strategic bomber could outfly its predecessors and safely evade Soviet interceptors. Yet it could not outrun the technology of surface-to-air missiles capable of tracking their targets while in flight. Attempts to salvage the Valkyrie as a penetrator capable of flying under the range of anti-aircraft missiles also proved fruitless, as it was unable to travel faster than Mach 0.95 at low altitudes. The loss of the second prototype marked a significant turning point in the project's existence. Only the less capable first prototype could provide the necessary and valuable data for the research program. The remaining plane flew for 2 more years, focusing on sonic boom data tied to the supersonic transport aircraft program. The data was incredibly valuable until the program was canceled. Currently, it's temporarily resurfaced as part of the development of Lockheed Martin's X-59 Quest, a 2016 low-boom flight demonstrator program scheduled for delivery in late 2021, and hopefully ready for flight tests in 2022. Only 2 XB-70 prototypes were completed at North American Aviation. The cancellation from the Kennedy administration stemmed from the increasing worry that manned bombers would soon become obsolete platforms. Since bombers are still used, these concerns, paired with the high cost of the program, disenchanted investors. Cancellation. The U.S. Air Force eventually gave up the B-70 aircraft. The program was officially canned in 1961. At that point, the development turned into a NASA research study on the effects of long-duration speedy flights. The two prototypes built were used for supersonic flight tests between 1964 and 1966. The tragic interruption of XB-70 No. 2 was due to its crash. The remaining Valkyrie bomber was prepared for a museum. This, the only surviving model, series number 62-0001, is now permanently housed at the National Museum of the U.S. Air Force in Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, close to Dayton, Ohio. The plane was flown to Ohio upon the conclusion of the testing program on February 4, 1969. It became their signature aircraft at the museum, featured on their letterhead, and as the main object in the design for the Valkyrie Cafe. In 2011, the plane was placed on display at the museum's research and development hangar, where other experimental aircraft are. The only XB-70 remaining was moved to the fourth hangar near the end of October 2015. Thanks for watching, and thanks again to Magellan TV for sponsoring this video and for offering a free one-month trial to Dark Skies viewers. Please visit try.magellantv.com/darkskies or click the link in the description below for access to more than 2,000 documentaries streaming across all your devices without interruption.